Ladies and gentlemen, we have made it. This is the go-home edition of TCAW Nitro, and we are less than a week away from our first ever CPV CAWllision Course. And by the end of tonight, we will know what our semifinal matches will be for CAWllision Course. Steve Johnson will take on Jayson Jones. Victory Musashi will square off against Gregory Black. Seth Adams will go one-on-one with Bart Turk. And tonight, father versus son, as War Dog Chuck Morgan goes one-on-one with Tank Morgan. Also tonight, Jon Payne will get a shot at revenge after he was attacked by Steven Morgan last week, as he and Steven Morgan will go one-on-one in a submissions matchup. And that is Stevie Van Hagar's music that's playing. Apparently he's got something on his mind as he's coming to the ring with microphone in hand. I'm pretty sure this has something to do with last week. During his match with Victory Musashi, Victory Musashi's manager, Takuya Yamaguchi, knocked out the groupie for whatever reason. Pimpin' D'Angelo Jackson came to the ring, scooped her up, took her to the back, and we have not seen her since, so I'm pretty sure this has something to do with that, but here we go. He's very calm and cool. Wow, we haven't seen her for the last week. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Pimpin' D'Angelo Jackson's music. Oof. It's not politically correct to call a woman that. Wow, challenging Steve Van Hagar to a match. Wow, Steve Van Hagar throwing down the gauntlet. A date with a groupie versus D'Angelo Jackson retiring or quitting from the TCAW. That's just going to be one interesting matchup for CAWllision Course. Stevie Van Hagar versus D'Angelo Jackson. Date with a groupie for the career. As Henry Upton and Sean O'Brien are backstage. Wow. Another big match for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Sean O'Brien is going to go one-on-one with Brian Turner, as those are two men that will be competing for the Internet Championship at CAWllision Course in a four-man battle royal. And ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get to our first match right now. And for the first time ever in the TCAW, it's father versus son. War Dog Chuck Morgan taking on his son and fellow War Dog Army member Tank Morgan. And it's kind of interesting why the competition committee would make the bracket like this, where these two could potentially have to face each other as throughout the entire tournament. Steven Morgan and Tank Morgan has done everything possible to make sure their father, War Dog Chuck Morgan, has advanced in the tournament. And now it's going to be interesting to see how this matchup is going to go, as, I mean, they've been working together throughout the entire tournament, and now they have to go one-on-one against each other. But, I mean, War Dog, as you can see, Steven Morgan is with his father coming to the ring, which looks like Tank Morgan's going to be by himself. I wonder if there's some kind of strife between three members of War Dog's army, as Steven Morgan is obviously siding with his father, War Dog. And you can see him there outside the ring. Now here comes Tank Morgan War Dog Chuck Morgan has cheated at every opportunity, at every chance in this tournament. Thanks to that guy, as you see walking in the ring, Tank Morgan and Tank's younger brother, Steven Morgan. And like I said before, it's going to be interesting to see how this matchup plays out between father and son. I can't think of a reason why these two would end up going up against each other, but whatever competition committee decides, that's the way it's going to go, I guess. Making his way into the ring. These two have two very similar styles. You can tell that War Dog Chuck Morgan has trained his two sons, as they have, like I said, similar styles to their father. As it looks like we're ready to go, the ref rings the bell. Here we go, father versus son. Stare down, War Dog to your left, Tank to your right. And you see Steven Morgan on the outside of the ring, these two circling around. And what we're going to have here... Now, big clothesline by War Dog Chuck Morgan. Going for the pinfall already. One, two, three, and that's it? War Dog Chuck Morgan is advancing in the TCAW tournament because of that? I think, ladies and gentlemen, I think we've just been duped. I think War Dog Chuck Morgan and his army has just made us all look a fool right now, as they had to have colluded with one another to help him advance, because this was one punch, and there's Jon Payne attacking Tank Morgan, and now that's Robbie Silk, and they're just laying the boots to Tank Morgan. I wonder where War Dog and Steven went. And this has got to be after the last few weeks. War Dog's army has done nothing but been a thorn in the side to these two individuals, Jon Payne and Robbie Silk, costing them both a chance at the title in the tournament, as they were either facing a member of War Dog's army or War Dog Chuck Morgan himself. And ladies and gentlemen, our next matchup, as you can see, is going to start getting ready here in a little bit. As there you see Steven Johnson preparing for the match, but... shockingly, War Dog Chuck Morgan is advancing to Collision Course and will face the winner of the Seth Adams and Bart Turk matchup. As now we're going to get ready for our second match, our second quarterfinals match, as Jayson Jones, as you see him there, is going to go one-on-one with Steve Johnson. But I'm still kind of speechless after what we just saw, as it appears that Tank Morgan laid down for his father. Chuck Morgan hit a lariat or a clothesline and got the 1-2-3 over his son, Tank Morgan, which, I mean, is shocking. I mean, I would do anything for my dad, but that's absurd. I mean, Tank Morgan just lost his shot at the TCAW World Heavyweight Championship, and all for his father. You know, I mean, It had to have been a plan. It reminds me of Kevin Nash and Hulk Hogan all those years ago, the finger poke of death that helped Hulk Hogan win the WCW Championship way back in the day. Not really way back in the day, but back in the day nonetheless. As Jayson Jones has made his way in the ring, and Jayson Jones hasn't had that easy of a time here in the tournament himself. As you see Steve Johnson there making his way to the ring. Steve Johnson last week defeated Joseph Hazelwood. Of course, that was with the help of Sean Cassidy, as Cassidy hit Hazelwood with the Cassidy cutter on the outside of the ring. And then, doing my notes in order here. And in episode number 2, defeated Fleezy the Snakehandler. seemingly with, well, with ease, because it was a hard-fought matchup. But it's been proven that you can get Steve Johnson out of his game by making him wait and making him be patient, as we have a collar and elbow tie-up to start the matchup. Last week, Jason Jones defeated Marcus Mercer, and if you didn't catch it, I would suggest watching what you didn't see after Raw, or what you didn't see on Raw, as Boofers the Clown came to the ring after Jason Jones defeated Marcus Mercer, but Marcus Mercer chokeslammed Boofers the Clown, and which was really easy, and I'm sure that's not what Boofers had in mind. And back in episode number 2, Jason Jones defeated Tanner Littleton, his first round matchup. So these two men have had really tough matchups. There's a big power slam by Steve Johnson as he's been in control here. Oh, there's a kick to the gut and a DDT. A nice maneuver there by Steve Johnson. I mean, I can see either one of these men advancing in the tournament and being some serious contenders. As didn't get all that clothesline, as there's a German suplex popping the hips is Jason Jones. Jason Jones with some punches now. Open has always going for here. A side effect, a nice side effect there by Jason Jones. Jason Jones going to the top turnbuckle. Oh, and there's a big flying clothesline that puts Steve Johnson down the mat. Now Jones just punching at the face of Steve Johnson. As I was saying, these two have both had really tough matchups. As there's a DDT. Quickly striking. Jason Jones going for the pinfall. 1, 2, and Steve Johnson kicks out at 2. Jason Jones goes into the ropes. Oh, and a punch to the face puts Jason Jones on the mat. Oh, and there's a big drop kick to the face. There's a kick to the gut by Steve Johnson. And there's a clothesline nicely done as now Steve Johnson is back in control. And Steve Johnson's going for the pinfall. 1, 2, and Jason Jones kicks out at 2. These two have both had really tough matchups here in the first two rounds of the tournament. Oh, and there's always going for an armbar. He's got Jason Jones in an armbar, but it might be just too soon. He hasn't really done anything to work on that arm as Jason Jones is able to get out of it. Jason Jones going to the top rope. Oh, and a missed missile dropkick. And now Steve Johnson, there you see, another submission hold. That's what Steve Johnson does best. I mean, well, Steve Johnson does a lot of things really good. He's good at the submission holds, but he also is good at the power game. I mean, he's got an all-around package. That's why I think he'd make a great world heavyweight champion, and is now a favorite, as I say that, is put down to the mat by Jason Jones, going to the top rope. Oh, and went for an elbow drop, but missed as Steve Johnson got out of the way. There's the quickness. And now he's got him in a pump handle slam. A nice pump handle slam by Steve Johnson. Now going for the pinfall, but Jason Jones grabs the rope. Steve Johnson, I wasn't sure how he would do in this tournament as there's a big clothesline. And now it looks like he's going for a camel clutch. Steve Jones, I wasn't sure how he would do in this tournament. He wasn't even in my top 5 to make it. Oh, and there he catches him. This Jason Jones trips him up. And now he's going for a he's got Steve Johnson in a sharpshooter. But Steven Jones, it wasn't even my top 5 to advance in this tournament or a top 5 favorites to win this tournament. But he's proved everybody wrong and has had a very strong showing in this tournament, being 2 quality opponents in the process. Ladies and gentlemen, we have about 10 seconds left before YouTube's required 15-minute break. So, folks, when we come back after this break, the conclusion, Steve Johnson.